Hello everyone, in this video we are going to build a very simple but powerful and functional music player with PiQT5. So let us look at what we are going to build. This is what we are going to build. So let me quickly add some songs. And then I can choose to play it, but the song is playing at the background. I can decrease the volume, increase it. Let me decrease it so that you can hear me. I can drag this slider forward, backward, and it will correspond. I can equally pause and unpause. I can also go to the, you see now it's select, the first one is selected. If I go to previous, it will automatically select the last song for me. That one plays. Previous. Can go forward. Then it will move to the first one. It's like this. I can go to the end and stop the song also. So this is what we are going to build. So if you like it, jump into the next section where we start building it from scratch. I have my project opened and set up in PyCharm, but as you can see from my project explorer, it is not an empty project. I have some files in here, a file called music.ui, and then the utils folder which contains images, and then the resource file. We are not building the music, the UI in this video, but if you scroll down to the description, there is a link to the starter file, which will take you to this GitHub page here. PyQT starter files. You are looking for this folder called a simple music player. It is inside it that you have the UR file and the utils also there. And then you can download it and then you get started. You can open it up in Qt Designer. This is what you will see. You can go ahead and then customize it as you want. So we will start by converting the UR file to Python. Let me open up the terminal here. It's called music.py. Okay, in this case, everything will be on one line so that it will not confuse you. And the output, I think the terminal is beginning to misbehave. Okay. PyUIC5-X for the incoming file, which is music.ui, and then the -o for the output file, which we also call music.py. And then it will create the file for us. Inside it, the it will try to link to the resource file here. But what I mostly do is to copy this and use it to create the resource file so that anytime I make changes to the UI and I rerun this command, I don't have to come and do a new import for the resource file. But the resource file is inside the utils folder, so this is what I'll do. I'll cd into utils and then I'll convert the resource file also. That one too has been converted for me, so I can close out from this terminal. That one, the syntax is a little different. The output file comes first and then followed by the UI file, or the resource file, sorry. So you can see that the import is treating it as if the music res RC is in the same directory, but currently as we speak, it's in the utils directory. So what I'll do is I'll click and drag and bring it up. Yes, refactor. So that I'll get it inside the same directory where the music.py is. If you have been watching my tutorials, you know that yes, I can run this music.py. It will not give me an error, but that is not how I usually like to do it, because chances are that I may like to change some portion of the UI as I go along building the software. It mostly happens in software development. I don't want to touch this file at all. I don't want to make even any modifications to it here. So I'll create another file, which I'll call main.py, which you can call it anything, where we will create a subclass of this UI here. A subclass of this one so that we can call it, and then it will be like we are using it just like that. So I'll quickly write this code. So we are importing from music, we are importing the UI simple player, and then the name of this class also will be simple music player. Okay, I can run this file also, but that is not what I'll run, because I'll write a lot of functions in here. I don't want to disturb the running of the file. Maybe I can make a mistake somewhere. So I usually also create a file which I call run.py. You can call it anything, which I also type in this code. So from now, from the main file, we want to import the subclass that we created, a simple music player. And so this is the file that we run. So when I run this one now, it should show up our music player for us. We'll bring this one down. And then now we can start the development. I'll not do it in this one. I'll not touch this run.py. I'll do everything inside this main.py file. I want to declare some initial stuff that we need throughout the whole application. So we'll store the songs in a list. So that one will be, let me say, init or something. So the file name of the list will be self.currentSongs. So current underscore songs should be equal to an empty list for now. And then we will need some global variables also. So global variables. One of the global variable for now, let's just declare the stop variable. We will use it a lot and let it be false. So stop should be equal to false. And then we also have to declare the player. We will need a player to play the music. So that player, we have to call it from Qt Multimedia. So self.player equal to Qt Multimedia. Qt Multimedia. And we have to import it here. And the Qt Multimedia dot QMedia player. This is the player that will play our songs for us. And I also want to set the initial volume of the player like when we start the application. So I will have to declare another variable here, self dot current volume or initial volume. You can choose to call it anything. Let me call it initial, or let me say current volume. So current underscore volume, which should be equal to 50. So I wanted the volume to start at 50%. So in here I will say self dot player dot set volume. We want to set the volume to self dot current volume so that it starts at 50%. I think it should be enough, at least for now, or for the initial configuration. Let me close this side so that you get more space. Maybe bring this thing to down. This is all for the initial configuration. So let us begin writing some code. So the first thing, of course, is to try and then bring in some music. And so that one will be, we define a function called open or add songs. That should be more appropriate, add songs. And then in here, we will import only audio files, but I have a list of file types that the player supports. It doesn't support every audio file that is out there, but it supports, let me say, most of them. So let's just bring the files in. So files underscore, the second one is the extension. We don't need it, that's why I put an underscore there. Should be equal to kill file dialog dot ask open file names. No, 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 get file names. I'm thinking in terms of tkinter. Yeah. Ask open file names is tkinter. This is get open file names. And in here we pass some parameters. So the first one, which is self, and then the second one, you can see that the caption, which is the what you show at the top, you add or add songs, let's say add songs. Another one that we bring in is also is the initial there, which is where not initial filter, initial is it not initial there? A green initial there is also tkinter something. I don't know why I'm thinking in tkinter. This is PyKT5. Directory. So if I give an absolute directory here, it will open, always open to that directory. But if I give this notation here, it will remember the previous directory where it's open to, and that is very, very good. We can also say that a filter now, that is the files that it should. You know, the window will open and you select files in there, but the files that should only display in the in that particular window is what is called the filter. And that will be a list, I would say supported files. And here is where I'll pass the list of all the supported files. So this is all the file types I know that it supports, and there should be enough, at least it's even more. So now if we get the files, that is the user select files, we can check to if files. Then you remember the list we created up there, we want to append everything inside the list. So self.currentSongs.append. There should be a for loop here. So for file in files. And then now self.append. File. Okay, and we also want to add the song to the list widget that is there. So self dot list widget dot add item, and then I'll add a file. So let's test this one out and see. But you know, I have to create the connection here. So connections, and then self dot action, the action that add songs is called action add songs. So triggered dot connect, I want to connect it to self dot add songs. Okay, and then to open this one up, let me see, select these songs. Okay, so we have our songs added, but you can see that we don't want it for the full path. It doesn't really make it nice. We only want the file name to show. We will not have a problem with it because we are already saving all this long path inside the current song list. So this place we can just save the file name, which we can do by os.path.basename and then file. When you call os.path.basename on it, it will just only bring the file name for us. Let's test it out and see. So you see that one only gives us the file names. Great. So now that our add songs is working, let's go ahead and then work on the playing of the song. So the one that will play the songs with def. Let's just say play song. And then we have to first get the current item that is selected in the list widget, which we can say maybe current index or current selection, which is more appropriate, equal to self.listWidget.currentRow. This one will give us the current row that is selected, and then we can use this one to index into the current song list. So maybe file or current song should be equal to self.currentSongs and then at this particular index, so current selection. This one will give us the song. And then we can now pass this song to our player. So we first declare it as a URL. So song URL now should be equal to QMedia content. And then here is QURL. We have not imported all of them. We have to import them. Let me quickly import the QMedia content. Okay. And then this one dot from local file. And then we pass in the current song. So we are getting it and we are passing it as a URL, which is good for the player to know. So now you can just now say that a player should play this particular song. So self.player.setMedia. We want to set the media to the song URL. And then now we can call the play on the cell on the player. So self.player.play. And this should play our song for us. Let us see. So self.playBTN. That is the name of the play button. Dot click. Not dot clear mask. Dot click. Dot connect. I want to connect it to self.play song. Okay, you can see that it's playing, but the volume will not come down. We have not implemented those functions, but you can see that you hear that the song is playing and this is not the safest way to go about this. In fact, if we open now and hit play, there's high chances that our software may crash. Yes, now it is not responding because it's looking for the index to play and it is not finding it. So one of the good practices is to wrap all of these in a try except block. So except, you can say play song error, and then that particular error there. So we can paste this our code here. And then now this one, if we click it, we see that it has not frozen. We can actually do a lot of things that we want to do. So it's best practice to keep your code in a try except block, especially for stuff like this. And so we know that now the song is working, but we have to put some checks here which will help us in the future, because we have to declare a stop, the global stopped, the stop variable that we created up there. Now we have to set it to false also. So stopped equal to false, because when it is playing, stopped is not true. So this one should be there. So that you know that you are safe. And also the next one, I think, would be the next appropriate thing would make the slider to move. Yes, that one should be the next target. So that one will come up here. I'll declare the function up here. And then move slider, I'll call it move slider. This one too, you say if stopped, that means we are calling the global stop variable. That is if stopped, which is false by default. So if this code is saying that if stopped is false, you can also write it that way. Then return, because if it is stopped, then the slider should not be moving, of course. Else, we want to refresh or update the slider. And this place we have to also check if the song is playing, because if it is paused, the slider should not move. If it is stopped, it should not move. If it is paused, it should not move. So how we check whether this player is actually playing a song is this: the self dot player dot state equal to kill, no, kill media player. I think we imported this thing, or we did not import it. Kill media player, let's import it from PyQt Multimedia. PyCharm does the, when I hover, does the importing for me automatically. So you see that it's importing them out here. One of the reasons I like the editor. Dot playing state. So we use this one to check. So this will check if it is playing. Then we want to carry out this particular operation. So self.musicSlider, that is the name of the slider that moves, dot set. I want to set the minimum to 0. And then I want to set the maximum to the duration of the song. And this is how I'll do it. So self.musicSlider.setMaximum to the duration of the song, which I can get by self.player. Dot duration. This one will give me the duration of the current song that is playing. And then the position also, I can set the position. So slider position should be equal to the particular time the song is playing. Like if it's like playing second 1, 2, 3, 4, that should be the slider position. So let's call that one slider underscore position should be equal to self dot player dot position. This one will give us the position of the song, and then now we can set the position of the slider. So self.musicSlider.set value, the current value to slider position. And that is it. This one will make it move. But we also have to update the time, but we can test this one out, it will work. And we have to call it here when we play the song. So self dot move slider should come, but if I play it, you see that it still not work. There's one more thing that we have to do. It's still not moving. There's one more thing that we have to do. We have to connect it to a timer, so it can come up here. Maybe call it slider timer. We can say self dot timer. I think this will only be one, so we can call it timer. It's called to kill timer. No. Let me import this. And here we pass in self. And then we want it to call repeat itself after every 1 second. So this action, we want to repeat it after every 1 second. So self dot timer dot start. Dot start. Well, and then we pass in 1000. This is in milliseconds, so that will be 1 second. And then we call it the timeout function. So self dot timer dot timeout when it's like the epoch or every 1 second reaches, this is what we want it to do. So dot connect, we want to connect the self dot move slider this to it. So this one will repeat itself after every 1 second and move the slider for us. So you can see that the slider is moving, but now if I click and drag it will come back. I've not yet implemented that, but you know that at least the slider is moving, and that is a great feat. So how to make it like drag it into the sun position is actually very, very, very simple. If we want that to happen, we don't even need to write a function. It's just a connection that you have to make. So self dot music slider dot slider moved. So dot slider moved, and then we want to get the integer. So if the slider is moved, we want to connect a lambda function. And in here, what we have to do is to set the position of the player, because if you set the position of the player, it will influence the position of the music slider, because in here we are using the slider to set the position here, the player position to set the slider position. So that is what we have to change here. So self dot player dot set position. Set position. Yes, this one. We want to set the position to self dot music slider dot value. And this, if this is confusing you, we when we move the slider, remember that the slider, we set the minimum to 0 and the maximum to the duration of the song. So all along the slider is the duration of the song. So wherever we drag it to, we can get the value at that particular position, which will be in seconds of the, if the song is 100 seconds, the least to be 0, the maximum be 100. So if you drag up to 50, that means you can get into 50 seconds inside the song. So once we set the player position here to the 50, it will set the position to 50, and the position will be transferred here as the current position, and then it will also be playing, and then the slider will also go to that position. So that is all that we have written up here, this long thing we have written up here. So now let's test it out and see. By the way, these shortcuts are also working, so I'm using the alternative A on Windows to open the songs. Select this one. See that now it is working. So that is how we set the position, quite easy. So let's just move on to another thing. Now I think we can implement the pause and unpause. Before that, there's one more thing that we have to do at this space. If we you recall that this one did not change, this test here, they didn't change. So we have to change it also when the slider is moving. That is also a part. So we can get the current time, that is the time that will be updating, to be time dot strf time. And this is we are converting a time, the seconds, to a particular format. And the format we want is this percentage H percentage M, no, percentage M percentage S, which is we want it in hours, minutes, and seconds. And what we want in the hours, minutes, and seconds, we want the time dot local time. And you see that we are, this one requiring some seconds, which will be the seconds. The I think the duration of the song should do that for us. So, but this one will not be the duration of the song. This the one that will be changing, so it will be the position of the song at any particular time. So to be self dot player dot position. But this one too will be given to us in milliseconds. So what we have to do is to divide by 1000 to get it in seconds. This one get the current song or the current time of the song for us at any point in time. And then the totals, if that's the total length or the song duration should be an appropriate way. So the song duration be very, very similar. In fact, I can even copy this one. But instead of position, this one will be duration. Yes. And then the labels that are there with the test, we have to now update them. So that one I can just say self dot start time label. I think that's, yes, that is the one. The first one that I'll be updating. I can say so the set test If I set text on it, I can now in an F string say this format current time. And the other one I think is self dot total time, should be something time. End time label dot set test to that one to be setting the test to the duration to song duration. This should work, I think. Let's test it out and see. Let me just bring in one. Okay, so I see that it's actually moving. I can update it here and now it's. But I think before we move on to the pause and unpause, the working on the volume will be a very great thing. I don't know how loud it will be at your end, especially when the song is playing, whether you hear what I'm saying or not. So let me implement the volume, then we move on to the pause and unpause and the rest. I'll put this one to in a try accept block. And I'll say maybe changing volume error or something like that. And in here, this what we want to, we are using the slider, the volume slider to change the volumes also. So we can say the self, or not even self, the current volume. You know, remember the current volume that we set here, we can change the value now to what it is currently on the slider. So if the user drags the slider, then we want to assign that volume now to the self.current volume instead of the 50. So this one will be equal to self not left self dot, I think it's volume slider should be the name, yes, dot value. So if the user now moves it to 40, the value will be 40 instead of the 50 that is up here. And then now we can set the player volume using this particular value. So self.player.setVolume should be, yes, then self.currentVolume. Yes. I think that should do it. And there's also some test label there, so we can set that one to self.volume, should be volume something. I think volume, yeah, volume label.setText. Should be the option, and then we set it to self.currentVolume again. So let's test that. Oh no, you have to make the connection up here. But I prefer to make it here, just under the, so that the sliders will be at one save. So self.volume slider dot slider mode to be similar to that one. We want the int, the value in an, as an integer dot connect. And then it should be a lambda function also. And self dot, I think we call it volume change. Yes, self.volume change. But this one will not pass anything, it will just be this one. Now the volume is high. So the volume now is very, very low. So at least now if I'm playing the song, I can bring it down for you to hear what I'm saying. I hope you hear what I'm saying again now. Now we can move on to implementing the pause, unpause, and the rest. The next one, we define pause and unpause. This player is meant to be a very simple player, very, very beginner friendly. Very soon we'll build an advanced one, but let's just get this beginner friendly one for the meantime. So this place, we will check if the song is playing, then we pause it. If it is not playing, or if it is not playing, it is can be that it's actually stopped. There's nothing in it at all. In that case, we cannot unpause it. We can only unpause it if the player has a file in it. You know, here we set the file, where is it? We set the media. So if the player has no media in it, we cannot unpause it. You can only unpause it if it has media in it. So you also have to check the state, and the state will help us do that. Other than that, we have written some complex logic, but PyQt helps us easily with that. So self.player, if self.player dot state, so we are just using the state equal to kill media player dot, this one will be playing state. You can use the playing state, that will know that it will be playing, that it has a media and it is playing. Then we can just call the pause on the player object. So self.player dot pause. Else self.player dot play. And after this should do. So we can connect it here. This will be pause push button. This one be pause and unpause. It'll work, but let's build the other ones before we test them all out. The previous and then the next. They shouldn't be difficult to implement at all, because we just have to get the other index and then that's all. So let's define next song. In fact, it'll be very similar to this. Let me just copy this side. But that one, yes, we still need the current selection, but we need the next index to be equal to current selection plus one. We just go there, and then this one will not be current selection, will be next index. And then, yeah, everything here should remain the same. Yeah, this thing should do. I think I did not spell the next well. Yes. And then if you are guessing for the previous, then it should be quite easier. This one, change this one to previous. And then we can change this one also to previous. In fact, it can be next, it will not give any issue, but it will just make it nice. And then this one will be minus one. And everything here should remain the same. Then let's implement the stop also. So let's define stop or stop song. We can't use the stop play and those ones, because PyQt has also them inside. It can cause confusion. So stop and then song, just to be safe. That one should be way, way easy to do. We just call the stop on the player. So self.player.stop. But after it stops, you want to also set the slider value to zero. So wherever it is, you come back to zero. So self.musicSlider.setValue to zero. And then you remember the places, these ones that we set the test, the labels were they that we set the test when there's the thing is playing. We have to now set this text down here to 0000. So this one will be 0000000. Yes, this is all for the stop, but it will be very, very safe to have these ones in dry except blocks. So it's going to be previous song error. You can paste this in, and then this one also, you can cut it. And then this one is next song error. We just want to be safe. Yes, so now we can connect everything up now. Yeah, we can duplicate them And this one will be self dot next btn, push button self dot next song. Yeah. So let's test it out and see. I need more files now. So all of them. Let me try the pause. It paused. The slider also stopped. The timer also stopped. So on pause, then. Keeps going, so that when I unpause it started moving, pause again, it stops, it now moves to 16 now. Let me check the stop also works. Let me play again. Okay, let me try and go to the previous song. It went to the previous song, but I have found a battery. Now if I press the previous song, the only song that will be playing is the very happy Christmas, which is now playing. So that it has repeated itself. And that is because after we got the index and subtracted one, we didn't change the selection to this one, which is now playing. And let's do that one in code. Let's move to the next song. So where is it? After we get this, after this, I think we can implement that. So to be self dot list widget dot set index should be set current row. And we want to set the current row to this index. Where is it? Next index. Yes. And for the previous song also, we can do the same thing. self.listWidgets.setCurrentRow to the previous index. Yes, this should work. Let's play. Now when I go press to start, it moves the selection to the next line and bring this one down. Next, and it moves it there. So this one is working now. What is left for us to do? I think we are left with the remove, add and those ones, because all this place is working. So we have our songs also, so let's work on these two and let's see. So the volume change, after the volume change as well, I'll implement those functions. So define remove one song, which should be quite easy to do. All we have to do is to get a current selection here like we always do, and then we take this item out of the list first. So self dot current songs dot pop, we pop the current selection, and then we take the item also away from the list widget. So self dot list widget dot take item, and we want to take the current selection, and remove all songs should be very, very easy, even more than easier than this one. So remove all songs. In that one, it will be self dot list widgets. Which one should we clear first? List widget dot clear. And then self dot current songs dot clear. But a very important step before all of this is to call the stop function to stop the song. Yes, so stop the song, clear the list widget, and clear this one. So let us add it up onto our connections here. I want all the actions to follow, so self dot this will be action remove selected should be connected to remove one song, and then action remove all should be also connected to remove all songs. Let me get rid of this space here. So now everything in our app should be working fine, except one I'm about to show you very soon, which is working but not like entirely professional or something like that. This one works, the pause, unpause, stop it, play it, next, previous, next, 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 but let me pause it now, and then remove this song, see that it goes, so I can play the current song. But I will not remove, okay, here let me remove all, and see, that one too also works, let me bring back the songs. So I think you can, the best way to also wrap these ones also in the try except for the ones for the remove selected and all, so that in case there's nothing in there, it will not crash our application. Now, if I select this one and play it, next, 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 if I hit next again, nothing happens. But if we come back to our terminal, we see a lot of error coming from the next song. And the truth is, if not that you have wrapped it in a try except block, it would have crashed the application. And so, you remember in the demo version, I showed you how that it automatically moves to the first one if it finds out that it's currently on the last song. Let's implement that one and then we can call it. So now we have to modify this code just a little bit. We still need the current selection, yes. But if current selection plus one equal to the length, the length of the self dot current songs, that means we are at the end. You know, the list index is, why I'm adding one, the index of the list starts at zero. So the first one is zero. But if you have a list of four items, the last one will be at index three, but the length will be four. So the length here, let's say you load in six songs. The last selection, if you get the value of the last selection by this, it will be five because the indexing is starting at one. But the length is six, so that is why I add one to check. So if you are wondering where the one is coming from, then that is it. So if this is the case, then next index here should be equal to zero. So I should start again. Else, next index, no, I can bring this one in. As next index is equal to this one, this one should fix it for the next. Let's test it before we implement the previous, at least to see that what we are proposing is working. So I'll just be forwarding it. And see that now it didn't stay there, the next is working as expected, and when it comes to our terminal 2, it's clean. So we can just impose that same logic on the I shouldn't have, it's after the current selection, so We are still checking, but this one, or as you have guessed, it will be previous index, and this line will also go away. But in this case, it will be just a little different. In this case, we are checking if current selection is zero. I have more than enough space here. So if the current selection is zero, then we want to now set the previous to this. This will not be it. If the current selection is zero, then the previous index, that means we are the first song and we want to go back. So that will be the length of the self.currentSongs, which will be one more than the index of the last song. So if you want the index of the last song, we have to subtract one from it. This you do. Else, previous index equal to this minus one. Yes, this should work. Yes, this should work. So let's test it. Okay, everything is working out now as we wanted it to. So that, my friends, is how we build a simple music player with PyQt5. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and learned something new. If so, be sure to like the video and subscribe if you are new. Until next time, I encourage you to keep on practicing. And as I said, we will be building a more advanced one very soon on this channel. So you can subscribe and stay updated and click the notification bell. Thank you very much for your time. The source code also here will be available in a GitHub repository. You can check the description. I'll see you another time with another video. Bye for now.